Good morning, church family and guests. Welcome to our Palm Sunday service. We are excited about today and about a chance to proclaim Hosanna. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. We had a chance earlier this week to pre-record this service, and we did so prior to finding out that one of our own church staff, who has been sick for the last couple of days in the hospital in Fort Worth, was diagnosed with COVID-19. Thankfully, according to his family, he is doing better day by day. We ask that you continue to pray for him and then pray for the rest of us as well here on church staff. We had a chance on Friday to go to the hospital, and all of us participated in the COVID-19 testing. At this time, our church staff, office staff specifically, and ministerial staff are isolating themselves within their homes and are waiting for the all clear. Thank you again for your prayers, and I know you will have a great service today as we celebrate the Savior of the world who entered into Jerusalem, coming in not to conquer as the Jews so desired for him to conquer over the Romans, but who came in to conquer our hearts and to conquer sin and death. Let's have a great day today as we serve and worship our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ.
Hey, Tommy and Eddie here to talk to you about something really great, Palm Sunday.
Yeah, that's the Sunday that we paint our palms purple to commemorate King Saul talking to that palm reader lady, and then we wave them in the air.
No, it's not.
Yes, it is.
No, it's
yes,
not.
Yes, it is. What Bible do you read?
Palm Sunday commemorates the triumphal entry of Jesus into Jerusalem. Now picture this. Jesus rode in on a donkey while the crowds put their cloaks and palm branches all over the ground, shouting, "Hosanna to the Son of David."
That's what I said. That's what I meant.
Okay, now picture this. Jesus's popularity was going viral. I mean, he just raised Lazarus from the dead in the same community just a few days earlier.
Wait, post-dead Lazarus was maybe at the very first Palm Sunday?
Yeah, probably.
That's so cool. I bet if he was there, he was probably like, "And you're a thriller, thriller, Jesus. You raised me from the dead when you said, get up, get up, get up, ooh!"
Now, to complete all of this, Jesus needed a donkey. Now, you'd think that a king or a prince would ride in on a horse, but not Jesus. He knew the message that he wanted to send. You see, a donkey represents peace. Anybody riding a donkey represented peaceful intentions.
Yeah, it says right here in Matthew 21, it says that Jesus sent two of his disciples to get him a donkey.
Yeah.
Hey, I wonder which two he sent.
Maybe Thomas.
I doubt it. I bet he sent Andrew. Andrew would totally do that. And probably Tony. I bet he sent Andrew and Tony.
Tony's not a disciple.
Oh, sorry. Tony is.
Still not a disciple.
What translation of the Bible do you read?
Jesus needed a donkey, so he asked two disciples to go get him a donkey. He told them they would find one in town, tied there next to a colt.
Yeah. And then he says, "Untie them and bring them to me. And if somebody asks you about it, you tell them the Lord needs them?" Jeez.
Yeah. What?
Well, Jesus told his disciples to go steal a donkey for him.
What Bible do you read? It doesn't say that at all.
I can't figure this out. I mean, Jesus, he changed water into wine. Cool. He fed the 4,000.
He fed the 5,000.
What?
He fed the 5,000.
It doesn't matter.
It does matter. Not the fourth. It's the 5,000.
We're splitting hairs.
I'm sorry.
Jesus fed a large group of people. And that's cool. He healed people with leprosy. He raises Lazarus from the dead, and then boom, he's like, "Hey guys, go steal me a donkey." I'm just saying, I don't think that's very WWJD.
The significance of Jesus riding on a donkey, which he did not steal, was to fulfill the prophecy that is found in Zechariah 9:9.
Yeah, but the...
And the king riding in on a lowly donkey with his way paved with palm branches. The palm branches symbolize triumph or victory.
The what?
The palm branches.
The bran...
Palm branches, Palm Sunday.
I thought it was the palm. They should call it Branch Sunday, because that's confusing. We all have palms with us all the time. I feel bad. I'm sorry, Palm Sunday.
Palm Sunday is a time for us to prepare our hearts for the agony of his passion and the joy of his resurrection. So this week, Let's cover the road to the cross with our hearts, our souls, and our minds as we reflect on the final week of Jesus' life.
And let's celebrate in anticipation the return of the King of Kings.
Good morning, church. We're so glad you've joined us for worship as we celebrate Palm Sunday. And we're celebrating, as most of you know, the triumphant entry of Jesus. And so we wave palm branches and shout Hosanna, which means save us. And so as we sing this song, Hosanna, we want you and your family, when it comes to the instrumental break a little bit later in the song, to wave your palm branches and shout Hosanna. And I'll let you know when that happens. So let's worship together. Hosanna. Praise is rising.
Praise is rising. Eyes are turning to you. We turn to you. Hope is stirring. Hearts are yearning for you. We long for you, 'cause when we see you, we find strength to face the day. In your presence, all our fears are washed away, washed away. Hosanna. God who saves us, worthy of all our praises. Hosanna, Hosanna, come have your way among us. We welcome you here, Lord Jesus.
Hear the sound.
Hear the sound of hearts returning to you. We turn to you.
Your kingdom.
In your kingdom, broken lives are made new. Oh Lord, you make us new.
When we see you,
'cause when we see you, we find strength to face the day. In your presence, all our fears are washed away. They're washed away.
Hosanna,
Hosanna, Hosanna. You are the God who saves us, worthy of all our praises. Hosanna, Hosanna, come have your way among us. We welcome you here, Lord Jesus.
All right, boys and girls, if you've got your palm branches, go ahead and wave them and shout Hosanna. And moms and dads, make sure and take some pictures or some video.
Face the day. In your presence, all our fears are washed away.
Sing that again.
'Cause when we see you, we find strength to face the day.
In your presence, Lord. And in your presence, all our fears are washed away. They're washed away. Sing Hosanna. Hosanna. Worthy of all our praises. Hosanna, Hosanna. Come have your way among us. We welcome you here, Lord Jesus. Hosanna, Hosanna.
Hosanna, Hosanna. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Welcome to our Palm Sunday service. It's a true blessing to have you join us here today. We are excited about coming together and praising our Lord and Savior. If you're a guest with us, I want to draw your attention to the description there within the video that connects you to our guest form. We'd love to go ahead and interact with you in some way. And if you wouldn't mind, go ahead and complete that guest form and just let us know how we can serve you. Also, within the description of this video, you'll notice several other forms. We have our prayer form. It's a way for you to share praises and prayer requests with us as a church. We also have a response form. And within that response form, you can share what God is doing in your lives and maybe also how we can help you. There's also a link to our online giving. I want to encourage everyone who attends here at First Baptist Church to continue serving and giving to the Lord as he calls upon you to do. And you can do that online, or you can also do that by sending a check in the mail, dropping it off in the drop box there on 4th Avenue in the drive-thru there. And would love to go ahead and continue to use what God has given us to serve our community. Today is Palm Sunday. And on that first Palm Sunday, a lot of great things happened as Jesus left Bethany and approached Jerusalem to begin the Holy Week, to begin Passion Week, to begin the road, the last 7 days to the cross. It was on that first Palm Sunday that people gathered along the road from Bethany to Jerusalem, and they grabbed these palm branches from those palm trees that lined that road, and they came and they waved them there as Jesus came to see them. Many others also laid them on the ground, all as a symbol and a way of saying that they are hopeful that Jesus would be their king. They were hopeful that he would come in and remove the oppression of the Romans, and that he would establish a new kingdom, a great kingdom, again, like the kingdom of Solomon, the kingdom of David. And they were very hopeful that he would be their conquering king. Well, Jesus did come to conquer, but he didn't come to conquer the Romans. He came to conquer men's hearts. He came to conquer sin and death. And that's exactly what he was going to do for everyone out there on the cross, and what he did for you and for me. When they were waving those palm branches and laying them on the ground, they were also crying, Hosanna! Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. That word Hosanna means please save us, or it means help, I pray. Save us now. They were truly looking to Jesus to be their conquering king. You know, this week the coronavirus became very real for many of us as Palapino experienced its first official case. Many are afraid that they would catch the virus or even transmit it to another, especially a loved one back home. So what are we to do in these kind of times? What are we to do during this coronavirus? Well, two things. First, we cannot deny the reality of this crisis. COVID-19 is here, and we need to take precautions necessary to keep us and others safe. That means we need to wash our hands. That means we need to stay home as much as possible. That means we need to do all that we can to help keep us and others safe. So we need to make sure we do not deny the reality of this crisis. Secondly, we must continue to place our hope on the one who can save us, Jesus. You know, I love the story of Jesus walking on water there in Matthew 14, verses 22 through 33. It's a wonderful story. It's an amazing story. Jesus had just fed the 5,000. And as he had fed them, he decided to send his disciples across the Sea of Galilee. He placed them in the boat and he sent them out into the sea. And then Jesus spent a little more time as he dismissed the crowd, and then he gathered himself up into the mountain and spent some time in prayer. Scripture tells us that for the disciples, that the wind and the waves were crashing against them there in their little boat there in the Sea of Galilee. It says it was around 3 to 6 a.m. in the morning, and they looked out into the sea and they saw what they thought was a ghost. It was Jesus. They were terrified, and Jesus told them, "Take courage, do not be afraid, it is I." And Peter looked out to Jesus, and he said, "If that is you, Lord, call me upon the water." And Jesus said, "Come." And so Peter got out of the boat, and he began walking on water himself to Jesus. But then Scripture tells us that he looked upon the wind, and he became frightened and began to sink. And then he says, "Lord, save me." Scripture tells us that immediately Jesus was there by his side with his arm reached out to Peter. And Peter was safe. Peter was safe. That word sozo in Greek is the word save, and it means to save a suffering one from perishing. Literally, it means here, it says, one suffering from disease, to make well, to heal, to restore to health, and to preserve one who is in danger of destruction, or to rescue. And that's exactly what Jesus did for Peter. And that's what he does for you and for me and all who place their trust in him. And he did that when he died on the cross for us. I love the last part of that story. The scripture tells us, of course, that Jesus reached down as soon as Peter said, "Lord, save me." Jesus reached down and Peter was safe. But notice in verse 32 of Matthew 14, the scripture tells us that the wind didn't die down, the waves didn't die down until they were in the boat. Peter was safe with Jesus there in the midst of his storm. You and I, we are safe in the midst of our storms when we too are with Jesus. And this Palm Sunday, we're going to remember the sacrifice of our Lord and Savior. We're going to remember the cost of our salvation. We're going to do so by looking at and then also participating in the Lord's Supper together. If not already done so, I want to encourage you to go ahead and gather those elements. Gather your bread, maybe the bread that you made this past week. We passed out some recipes of both unleavened and leavened bread. Maybe you made your own bread using those recipes, or maybe one of your own recipes. Maybe you've got another loaf there laying around that you purchased in the store today. Maybe you've got some crackers. Whatever it is that you have for your bread, gather that, and then gather your juice and get ready if you haven't already and prepare for the Lord's Supper. As we pray and continue our worship with a couple more songs, I just want to spend some time just examining your heart and preparing to partake of the Lord's Supper. Would you pray with me? Heavenly Father, we come before you today. We just ask that you do examine our hearts. Please reveal to us anything that's in our lives that's not of you. Anything that needs to be confessed, anything that needs to be given over to you. Help us to do so today. God, we love you and we thank you for your love for us. We thank you for sending your son Jesus on that first Palm Sunday to ride into Jerusalem. He did come to save us from our sins. And we thank you for that. We thank you, God, for this day that we have, that we can cry, "Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord." In Jesus' name, amen.
My hope is built. My hope is built on nothing less than Jesus' blood and righteousness. Not trust the sweetest frame, but wholly trust in Jesus' name.
Let's sing that again. My hope.
My hope is built on nothing less than Jesus' blood and righteousness. Trust the sweetest frame, but wholly trust in Jesus' name.
Christ alone.
Christ alone, the cornerstone, weak made strong in the Savior's love through the storm. He is Lord, Lord of all. When darkness seems to hide his face, I rest on his unchanging grace. In every high and stormy my anchor holds within.
My anchor holds.
My anchor holds within the veil. Christ alone, cornerstone, weak made strong in the Savior's love. The storm, he is Lord, Lord of all. He is Lord, Lord of all.
Christ alone,
Christ alone. In the Savior's love, through the storm, he is Lord, Lord of all.
Christ alone.
Christ alone, the cornerstone, weak made strong, in the Savior's love. The storm, he is Lord, Lord of all. He shall come with trumpet sound. Oh, may I then in his righteousness alone, faultless to stand before the throne.
Christ. Christ alone. Christ alone, the cornerstone, weak made strong in the Savior's love. Through the storm, He is Lord, Lord of all. Sing it out, Christ alone. Christ alone, the cornerstone, weak made strong in the Savior's love. Through the storm, He is Lord, Lord of all. Let's pray together. Father God, thank you for being our cornerstone. And Father, through this storm that we are going through, we know that we stand on solid ground because our hope and our trust is in you, God. Lord, thank you as we celebrate and think about your sacrifice at the beginning of this week and then going toward Easter. God, we thank you for your Son and for sending him to be the sacrifice for our sin. And we thank you for the cross. And we ask all this in his precious name, Jesus. Amen. There's a place.
There's a place where mercy reigns and never dies. There's a place where streams of grace flow deep and where all the love I've ever found comes like a flood, comes flowing down.
At the cross.
At the cross, at the cross, I surrender my life. I'm in all of you, I'm in all of you. Where your love ran red and my sin washed white, I owe all to you, I owe all to you, Jesus. There's a place where sin and shame, my heart has peace with God and forgiveness. Where all the love I've ever found comes like a flood, comes flowing down.
At the cross.
At the cross, at the cross, I surrender my life. I'm in all of you, I'm in all of you. Where your love ran red and my sin washed white, I owe all to you, I owe all to you.
Here my hope is found.
Here my hope is found. Here on the holy ground, here I bow down, here I bow down, here. open wide. Here you saved my life. Here I bow down. Here I bow at the cross. At the cross I surrender my life. I'm in all of you, Lord, I'm in all of you. Where your love ran red and my sin washed white, I owe all to you. I owe all to you. At the cross, at the cross, at the cross, I surrender my life. I'm in all of you. I'm in all of you. Where your love ran red and my sin washed white, I owe all to you. I owe all to you. I owe all to you. I owe all to you, Jesus. Jesus. Amen.
Following Jesus' triumphal entry on that Palm Sunday, Jesus weeps over Jerusalem. He cleanses the temple. He teaches about faith, and he foretells of his death, among other things. And then prior to gathering his disciples up there in the upper room, then once he is there in the upper room, he washes the disciples' feet. He calls out his betrayer. Then he participates in the Passover and institutes the Last Supper. And he also continues teaching his disciples. It's there during this Last Supper, there in that upper room, that Jesus gives him and gives them John 14:27, that says, "Peace I leave with you, my peace I give to you. Not as the world gives do I give to you. Do not let your heart be troubled, and do not let it be fearful." This wonderful peace is made available by Jesus' sacrifice on the cross. Paul, in his letter to Romans, in Romans 5:1, writes, "Having been justified through faith, we have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ." And then in Colossians 1:20, he writes, "This peace comes through the blood of his cross." It's there in the upper room that Jesus has a wonderful meal with his disciples. This meal was the Passover meal. The Passover meal was a meal that commemorated the Lord providing a Passover and protection there during the 10th plague in Egypt. It helped the Israelites to remember all that God had done for them. And it was a time of celebration. And Jesus used this Passover, this time of remembering God freeing the Israelites from slavery from Egypt, to then transform it to an opportunity to talk about how God now is, through his Son Jesus Christ, delivering us all from the slavery of sin. And Jesus does this by relating the bread of the Passover to his body, and the cup as being his blood shed for them. Jesus makes the bread a cup and cup a sign of God's new covenant promise. This promise is that all who believes in him will not perish, but have eternal life. And Jesus tells his disciples to do this as often as they can in remembrance of him. He asks his disciples to participate in this Lord's Supper from time to time, and he does that so that we all can remember the sacrifice that he gave for our salvation. And by participating and practicing and partaking of the Lord's Supper, by taking the bread and taking the cup, we do remember what Jesus did on the cross. And not only does the Lord's Supper help us to remember all that he has done, but it unites us as fellow believers in Christ. The Holy Spirit unites us spiritually, but as we practice both baptism and then practice the Lord's Supper in observance of what God has done, we unite with other believers, and it connects us to one another and to God. Jesus, as the Passover was a memorial to be regularly repeated, asked us to regularly repeat the Lord's Supper. And when we partake of the bread and the juice by faith, we participate in what Christ's broken body and shed blood obtain for us: forgiveness, reconciliation, adoption, and all the other blessings of the new covenant, including healing from all diseases. At this time, we are going to partake of the Lord's Supper. And I want to make several invitations before we do. First, I want to invite anyone that is watching this broadcast, anyone maybe listening on Mixlr live stream, to consider an invitation to receive Christ as your Lord and Savior. Scripture tells us that all of us have sinned and fallen short of the glory of God. We are sinners, and we need God in our lives. But thankfully, God loves us, and He demonstrated His own love for us that while we are sinners, Christ died for us. You know, the wages, as Romans 6:23 says, of sin is death. But the gift of God is eternal life in Christ Jesus. And all who believe in Him and confess Him as Lord, as Romans 10:9 and 10 says, will be saved. If you don't know Christ as your Lord and Savior, I want to encourage you right now, right here today, to cry, Hosanna, Lord, save me. Do that. You can do that by just praying a prayer, a simple prayer. Let me lead you in a simple prayer to receive Christ as your Lord and Savior. If you want to do that today, just repeat after me this prayer. Just say, Dear Jesus, I believe in You. I believe that You died on the cross for my sins. Forgive me of my sins. Come into my life. Lead me, guide me, direct me to live the life that You desire for me to live. I love You. Be Lord of my life today and forever. Amen. If you just prayed that prayer today, I want to encourage you to respond by using the response form there in the description of this video or there on our website. Let us know that you just received Christ as your Lord and Savior, and we'd like to be able to walk with you through the next steps of what it means to be a Christian and what it means to follow Christ. Secondly, I want to invite others out there today to consider something else that maybe God is doing in your life. I want to invite you to recommit your life to Christ. Recommit your life to follow after Him, to be all that God has called you to be. You can just do that right there in your living room or wherever you might be today, and just ask God to work on your heart and to recenter it on You. Maybe God's going to be asking you to give up something in your life or to change some behavior or some relationship. Trust in Him. He knows what He's doing. Surrender your life to Him. Recommit to Him today. There might be some other decision that you have. Maybe you want to join this church. You can do so right now, today. You can just, again, through a private message or through one of the response forms, commitment forms, guest contact forms, you can use to just let us know that you'd like to know more about what it means to join First Baptist Church of Mineral Wells. And we'll reach out to you and talk with you about what all that means. Maybe you want to follow in obedience of baptism or have some other decision. Here in just a moment, we are going to sing one of our final songs, and as an opportunity for you to just respond to the Lord, you can do that after this service is over with on our Facebook page, on live, again, through private message or through one of the response forms. But whatever God has done in your life today or is doing in your life today, please let us know. As we prepare to take the Lord's Supper, I want to talk with you a little bit about who the Lord's Supper is all about. The Lord's Supper is available for anyone who knows Christ as their Lord and Savior. Whether you're a member here at First Baptist Church or not, we invite you to participate, if you know Christ as your Lord and Savior, in the Lord's Supper. And as we prepare to partake of the bread and juice, let me read to you what took place there in that upper room as the Lord instituted the Lord's Supper. It's from Luke chapter 22, verses 14 through 20. It says, "When the hour had come, he reclined at the table, and the apostles with him. And he said to them, 'I have earnestly desired to eat this Passover with you before I suffer. For I say to you, I shall never again eat until it is fulfilled in the kingdom of God.' And when he had taken the cup and given thanks, he said, 'Take this and share it among yourselves. For I say to you, I will not drink of the fruit of the vine from now until the kingdom of God comes.' And when he had taken some bread and given thanks, he broke it and gave to them, saying, 'This is my body, which is given to you. Do in remembrance of me.' And in the same way, he took the cup, and they had eaten, saying, 'This cup, which is poured out for you, is the new covenant in my blood. But behold, the hand of the one betraying me is with mine on the table. For indeed, the Son of Man is going as it has been determined. But woe to the man by whom he is betrayed.'" You know, so we come to a time now of partaking the Lord's Supper. So right now, right where you are, take some time in prayer and thank the Lord for humbling himself and looking out for you and for your interests by dying on the cross. Fathers, mothers, those leading your family, if you would, just right now, go ahead and start gathering your family together. Or if it's just you right there in your own home, just with you and the Lord, you spend some time in prayer. Just gather right now, pray over this time, and then when ready, partake of the Lord's Supper. First, take the bread, pass that out to every believer there with you today. And then together, eat the bread. Then take the juice and pass that out to every believer there in the room with you today. And then together, partake of the juice. We'll give you a few minutes to partake in the Lord's Supper. Once complete, join us in singing, "Jesus Paid It All."
Savior say, I hear the Savior say, thy strength indeed is small, child of weakness, watch and pray, find in me thine all in all. Jesus, Jesus paid it all to him. Left a crimson stain, he washed it white as snow. But now I find thy power and thine alone can change the leper spots and melt the heart of stone. Jesus paid it all, all to him I owe. Sin had left a crimson stain, he washed it white as soul to save, my lips shall still repeat. Jesus paid it all, oh, to him I owe. Sin had left a crimson stain, he washed it white as snow. Sin had left a crimson stain, he washed it white as snow. He washed it white as snow. He washed it white as snow. Single, praise the one. Oh, praise the one who paid my debt and raise this life up from the dead. Oh, praise the one who paid my debt and raise this life up from the dead. Oh, praise the one who paid my debt and raise this life up from the dead. Oh, praise the one who paid my debt and raise this life up from the dead. Oh, praise the one who paid my debt and raise this life up from the dead. Oh, praise the one who paid my debt and raise this life up from the dead. Jesus. Life up from the dead. Oh, praise the one who paid my debt and raised this life up from the dead. Oh, praise the one who paid my debt and raised this life up from the dead. Oh, praise the one who paid my debt and raise this life up from the dead. Amen.
Thank you for worshiping with us this Palm Sunday. It's a true joy to be able to do that online with you. If you made a decision today or have some kind of response that you want to share with us, please do so either through a private message or using one of our forms online from our website. If you took one of those Palm Sunday pictures or videos earlier this morning, we want to encourage you, please go ahead and upload that to our Facebook page. And for Easter, which is just next Sunday, we're looking forward to celebrating Resurrection Sunday with you, and we have a mission for you. We'd like for you to take a video of yourself and or your family, starting with for me, Easter means, and then you fill in the blank. So for me or for us, Easter means, and then you tell us what it means to you. There's a post that tells you how to upload that. Please just go ahead and look on that on our Facebook page, and it'll tell you how to get that to us. And what we want to do is kind of compile all as many videos and all the videos that we get in together, and then use that in our service on Easter. We look forward to worshiping again with you next Sunday. And if you think about it, why don't you also take a picture of yourself on Easter Sunday and upload that so that we can kind of enjoy seeing everybody in their Sunday best or in their pajamas. Have a great day, and remember, we serve a conquering King.
Honey, come on. Easter service is starting.